see, right? Anybody know how to work one of these? Do you? Can you fix that for us? All right, you turn that. Good, good. And, oh, it's stuck. Can we get it back now? These things can get kind of complicated. Because it seems like no matter where you turn them, it messes everything up. Now, some of the things you can do, like if you went like this, and maybe like that, and like that, and maybe get one side done. But then, you know, when you want to do the other side, if I want to move that piece out of there, let me see, I suppose I could do that. But now that one's gone. Well, no, that's not right. So if I go around here, move that down, move that down. Now that one's right again. But now that one's wrong. So how do you fix one of these things? Well, you could try and try and try and just keep playing around with it until you got it done. But, you know, there's no guarantee that it'll work. Or you could use this. You know what this is? These are, you know what that is? What are they? These are the directions on how to fix the Rubik's Cube. Now, if you look at these, does this look like it's pretty simple directions? You know, they look kind of strange, and they take a little study, but after you do it for a while, you can probably get it done. So if I studied this and worked on it and did what the sheet said, you think I could get this fixed? No, you can't. And I have. And I'll probably do it again later. But I'm not going to take it because it takes me a long time to get it done. I'm not like those guys on TV that can do it really fast. But when you're thinking about things that are really difficult to do, you know, when we want to share our faith, and when we want to bring someone into God's kingdom, how hard is that? You know, a lot of times, it's kind of like trying to do one of these things. Because no matter what you say, no matter what you do, it seems like everything's going the wrong way. Unless you have the directions. Now, I have the directions here for the Rubik's Cube. Where do you suppose we can find directions for what God wants us to do? In the Bible, right? Now, the Bible's a pretty big book, right? And if you read through it, do you understand everything that you read? Do you? That's amazing, because I don't. There's still some things that I don't get. I'm studying, I know more about it than I did before, but there's still some things in there that I need to work on. But if we do what God tells us to do in the Bible, you suppose good things are going to happen? You suppose we're going to bless people, and God will bless us? And do you think that things are going to turn out the way that God wants them to? I think that they will. Now sometimes, you know, like with this thing, to fix it, you have to move things around, you know, in ways that you wouldn't think. Because now I got a bed all over the place there, but it's not that hard to do one side if you know how to do it. Because if you just go like this and like this and like this, well then the red side's there again. But you know, if you practice it, you get pretty good at it. And it's the same thing with the Bible. Sometimes the Bible tells us to do things that we might not understand. But if we practice it, we get pretty good at it. So you suppose it's important to study the Bible? Suppose it's important to talk about the Bible? Suppose it's important to do what the Bible says? You think maybe we should pray and ask Jesus to help us with that? Why don't we do that? Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for giving me life. And for giving me forgiveness, and for giving me your Bible. Teach me to read it. Help me to understand it. And give me faith to live it. Bless me tonight when I hear your word, that the Holy Spirit comes to me, and I can grow close to you.